Naham bibhemiti ati bhayanakasya. Naham bibhemiti ati bhayanakasya. Jyohar konetra bhukuti ravaso gradanta. Antasrajah khatajo sankukarnad. Nirahad abhita digbhad ribhinnana kagra. Trasto asmi aham kipanavasalo dusahogro. Sangsar jakrakadanad. Grasatam panitam naham bibhemite ati bhayanakasya jivhar konetra bhukti ravaso gradangstra antasrajah khatajo sankukarnad nirhad abhita digbhad ribhinnana khagrad trasto asmi aham kipanavasalo dusahogro Sangsar chakra kadanad grasatam pranitam. Gaudiya Goshtipati Sisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told that logic or argument, the absolute truth become vanish. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told logical interpretation cannot stand in the way of that absolute truth. If we want to take shelter of logic and argument, then that absolute truth become vanish in front of. Cannot. Is a main thing. Actually, those bonded soul, somehow they are trying to get out of different kind of problems. All different kind of problems going to put them in trouble. But actually, Prahlad Maharaj speaking, Ho Prabhu Nishingadev, I don't fear your those fearful appearance. I mean, Nishingarup, very fearful. Prahlad Maharaj speaking, Prabhu, I never fear. You are this Nishinga Roop. Though Brahma, Sankar, you know, they become very fearful after looking this Nishinga Roop. Prahlad Maharaj speaking, no, I don't fear. But I fear this material samsara. This material samsara, I fear very much. Very dangerous. This material samsara is so dangerous, so dangerous. Ananta param kila sadda sastram, one word we discuss before, you can remember. Until and unless we are not going to take shelter of aprakita sabda brahma, until and unless we are going to take shelter of that aprakita sabda brahma, we cannot get respite of this material samsara. Anyhow, this material samsara can, you know, put us in trouble, we can die. That's why Nishingadev praying in front of, Prahlad Maharaj praying in front of Nishingadev, Prabhu, Naham bibhemi, Naham bibhemi te ati bhayanakasya. He be very fearful, your Nishingarup. Everybody fear, but I don't fear. I only fear this material samsara. Fearful this material samsara I. Actually, point is that Gaudiya Math, Prabhupada speaking, Gaudiya Math is a prakita hospital. Gaudiya Math is transcendental hospital. I can come to this point after some time. You can remember in 11th canto, we find that this material body we are going to lose any day, any time. Tatrapi durlabam manne vaikunthapiya darshanam. Tatrapi durlabam manne paikunta priyadarshanam. It is very rare. It is very, very rare that we can meet with a pure Vaishnava. It is very, very rare. Tatrapi durlabam manne vaikuntha priyadarshanam. This material body going to, we are going to leave this material body very shortly. But if we can meet with a prakita sadhu, in that case we have the chance to hear transcendental shabda brahma. Without a prakita sabda brahma, without the shelter of prakita sabda brahma, we cannot come out of this material world. Actually, point is that Prahlad Maharaj speaking, you already I discussed, you can remember this same point. Actually, Prahlad Maharaj speaking that aprakita sabda brahmo, I am not going to hear aprakita sabda brahmo. I have no capacity. I have no capacity to hear a prakita sabda brahma. That's why I am in problem. If you can bless me, that then I can grow my capacity to hear a prakita sabda brahma, then I can go out of this material world. Actually, point is that Prabhupada speaking, this is Gaudiya hospital. Prabhupada speaking, this is Gaudiya hospital. So in Gaudiya hospital, all Gaudiya devotees, those who are actually like Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Keshav Goswami, all Guru Varga giving us treatment. But material people, they cannot understand. Material people, they cannot understand what kind of benefit Gaudiya Math going to give to this material world. They cannot understand. On the contrary, they are having some envious attitude. They are speaking what Gaudiya Math doing. Gaudiya Math not doing any social service. Gaudiya Math not doing any social service. We are at least doing some social service. So what Gaudiya Math doing, they cannot understand. Prabhupada writing one nice article in which Prabhupada speaking that actually Gaudiya Math going to give some benefit of those jivatma. Material world, they those who are different kind of societies there, organization, they are doing some service for this material world. Material world. They are giving service to this body, material body and material mind. Material mind, material body. But Gaudiya Math actually giving benefit to this Atma, spirit. Prabhupada in article speaking, this is Gaudiya hospital in which we have some seat vacant. In this Gaudiya hospital, we have some seat vacant, we are going to take admission some patient. So if there is some patient, they can come. Popa speaking, already some patient are there inside our Gaudiya Math. Number one bed, there is one patient, he is having material affinity. He is also habituated to take tea secretly. He is going to utilize the association. Actually, he is going to take undue advantage of Guru Kipa to get some material facility. This way, number one cabinet patient is suffering. Number two, that patient is actually very angry attitude all the time, with full of karma. This is a different kind of symptom, Prabhupada speaking. In different beds, those patients there, Gaudiya devotees, actually those who are giving treatment to them, they are actually Gaudiya devotees who are going to give treatment to them, they are trying their best to cure them, their disease actually. So, through a prakita sabda brahma, they are going to give treatment to them. Through a prakita sabda brahma, they are going to give treatment to them gradually. So, today or tomorrow they can get some benefit actually. So now actually, we are going to resume our Gita discussion. Actually, Arjun putting different kind of question. Arjun putting different kind of question in front of Krishna. Up to which point we discuss, you can remember. You can remember up to which point we discuss. Chapter second, actually, 45 number sloka. 45 also. Bhogaisajya prasaktyanam taya pohito chetasam vyavasayaptika buddhi samadhu navidhiyate. Bhogai sarjo prasaktyanam taya purhit chetasam vyavasayatika buddhi samadho na vidhiyate. Actually, bhogai sarjo prasaktyanam taya purhit chetasam. Bhogai sarjo prasaktyanam mean actually those bonded soul having different kind of desire, actually enjoying mood. Bhogai sarjo bhog mean enjoyment, oisajya mean affluences, prasaktyanam mean actually their affinity, bhogaisajya prasaktyanam, taya apurhita chetasam, by different kind of enjoying mood, their consciousness going to drop. Bhogaisajya prasaktyanam, taya apurhita chetasam, vyavasayatika buddhi samadhu na vidhiyate. Vyavasayatika buddhi mean settlement. After analytical idea, he is going to settle down his, you know, logic. Vyavasayatika buddhi samadhu na vidhiyate. Vyavasayatika buddhi samadhu na vidhiyate. Vyavasayatvika buddhi samadhu na vidhiyate. Actually, there in Veda different kind of lucrative offer there. In Veda, different kind of lucrative offers are there. By different kind of offer, lucrative offer, their mind is actually, you know, their mind is actually, and actually, their mind is actually going to get attachment with us. For them, actually, those who are going to get different kind of, you know, enjoying mood, their mind, they cannot settle down their mind, so they cannot do actual bhajan. They cannot actually do actual bhajan. They cannot start bhajan, because it is impossible for them. Actually, traigunna vishaya veda nistraigunna bhavarjuno. Traigunna vishaya veda nistraigunna bhavarjuno. Actually, Bhagavan Sri Krishna giving advice to Arjun. Hey Arjun, actually by the three modes of material nature, those three modes of material people, they are in bondage condition. Traigunna vishaya veda, all your sense organ can only understand this material enjoyment. Traigunna vishaya veda, nistraigunna bhavarjuno. First of all, try to go out of the influence of material influence. In that case, nirdando, when your mind can attain equipoised situation, nirdando means equipoised situation, not going to expect anything, no attraction, nothing. Nirdando, dando mean actually fighting. Dando mean actually, nirdando mean actually out equipoised position. Dando mean fighting. Inside mind some ups and down going on. Nirdando, nirdando nitto sattvasto nirjogo khem atmabhano. Hey Arjun, oh Arjun, you try to go out of the influence of three modes of nature and try to settle down your mind, and you try to, you automatically you can reach such a position in which you can ignore all different kind of respect, fame, name, or somebody going to insult, you can ignore it in this situation. Nitya sattva, those who are having nitya sattva mean, nitya sattva mean, sattva gun actually, rajo tamo sattva is admixture. Any bonded soul, they are not purely sattva, they are not purely rajo, they are not purely tamo. Some admixture there. But Krishna advising Arjun, hey Arjun, nitya sattva, those who are nitya eternal existence, they have the eternal world. Nitya sattva, those who are that kind of sadhu, you will have to get that association of that kind of sadhu. Madhyatva buddhi yoga lab kariyan, I am always trying to give them buddhi yoga, but they cannot accept it. What to do? Madhyatva buddhi yoga lab kariya yogokhyam anusandhan rohitha. Yogokhyam, nirdando nitya sattvasto nirjogokhyam atmaban. Nirjogokhyam atmaban. Yogokhyam, yogokhyam mean actually what you have already, you like to protect it. Krishna can give protection. What you already have, what you don't have, you are expecting all. Krishna, only Bhagavan Sri Krishna can take the responsibility to protect your yoga and khem. No other demigods or gods. Yoga khem. So, Krishna speaking nirdando nitya sattvastho nirjoga khem atmavan. So, taigunna vishaya veda nistraigunna bhavar juno nirdando nitya sattvastho nirjoga khem atmavan. Atmavan means you try to concentrate your mind, try to search inner self. Atmavan, try to concentrate. Atmavan madhyatva buddhi yukta ho. What? This. Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving different kind of explanation, so many things. Actually, now 46 number sloka speaking. Javan artho udapane sarvatoho sankluto dake tavan sarveshu vedeshu brahmanasso vijanataha. Javan artho udapane. Javan artho udapane means small source of water. If you have one small source of water, have some restriction. Because if you are going to take bath, you cannot use it for other purpose. You are going to wash your clothes, you cannot use it for drinking. Javan artho udapanes sarvatoho sankplutodake. Sankplutodake. Sankplutodake means there is big source of water. If there is big source of water, in that you can use that water for any purpose. Javan artho udapane sarvatoho sankplutodake. Tavan sarveshu vedeshu brahmanasso vijanataha. If you have small well or small pond, there you can use it, that water, not for all purpose. But if you have big source of water, in that case you can use it for all different kind of purpose. You can use it. That's why javanartho udapane sarvatoho sankplutodake tavan sarveshu vedeshu brahmanaso vijanataha. So in Veda, tavan sarveshu vedeshu brahmanaso vijanataha. Actually, in Veda, different kind of offer given to you, ritualistic activities, if you do, if you worship this demigod, if you worship that demigods, you can get different kind of result. But actually, ultimate goal of Veda is to show Krishna. Veder potigya ei kahe Krishna re. Veda, it is the resolution of Veda to show the lotus feet of Krishna. Vedasya sarvai rahame vivedyo. Vedasya sarvai rahame vivedyo. Actually, Krishna speaking in Gita. So, if you are interested to do Krishna bhajan, Bhagavad Upasana, then all different purpose written in Veda for those bonded soul, if there is, if for bonded soul, different kind of offers are there, otherwise they cannot get inspiration. So, different kind of result they can get, for they can worship different kind of demigods, like those who are going to worship Kartik, you know, Kartik, the son of Durga, they are interested to get some son. If they have no son, they like to get. So, they are going to worship Durga to get material influences, different kind of demigods they are worshipping. But through Bhagavad Upasana, if somebody is interested to do Bhagavad Upasana, in that case he can get all result, all purpose can be served. And, but through Bhagavad Upasana, they can get all, can serve all purpose. Not that, this, that, can. Material people, they are always concentrating on different kind of benefit, material benefit. They are going to do Satyanarayan Puja. Satyanarayan Puja, actually those material, in this material world, you can find some people, they are doing Satyanarayan Puja to get some material benefit, to go out of problem, this, that, that. Satyanarayan Puja they are doing today, it somehow they are not going to get any benefit out of this Satyanarayan Puja. Tomorrow they can say this is Mithyanarayan. Today they are speaking this Satyanarayan Puja. If Satyanarayan is not going to give anything which is dangerous, he can say is Mithyanarayan. This way. So their unstable mind cannot give them facility to settle down their mind and start Hari Bhajan. That's why those who are actual Vedagya, Vedobid, Vedobadi and Vedobid. Vedobadi means those who are only speaking Veda. They remember some sloka from Veda and speaking something from Veda. They have no realization. And those who are going to speak anything about Veda out of their realization, they are actually Vedobid. So actual Brahman, those who are Vedobid, so out of Krishna Bhakti, they understand that if we are going to do Krishna Bhakti, this is actually vital thing, we can get everything. So this Bhakti Yoga, if somebody can settle down their mind and start Krishna Bhakti, is called Vyavasayatika Buddhi. Vyavasayatika Buddhi, material people, they have some branches. Their intellect in different branch, running towards this and that. But Vyavasayatika Buddhi means they already settled down their mind. They are concentrating on one thing, that is Krishna Bhakti can give me everything. That is called Vyavsayatika Buddhi. Number 47 slog, Karmanya Vadhikaraste Ma Falishu Kadachana Ma Karmo Falo Hetur Huma Te Sangastu Akarmani. Karmanya Adhikaraste. Bhagavan Sri Krishna giving advice to Arjuna. Arjuna, only you have your right to do karma. You have no right to think about result. Karmanya Vadhikaraste Ma Falishu Kadachana. Actually, you have your right to do karma. Because you cannot stop your karma. Those who are Mayavadi, they are speaking Naishkarma. They don't like to do any karma. Because they think karma means a cause of bondage. But karma, actual material people, they are doing karma, and devotees, they are also doing bhakti karma, that not actually karma, it looks like karma. Morning time, one devotee cooking in mart with salary 5,000 rupees. Morning time, he is cooking. So, he is doing seva and taking money, 5,000 rupees. His seva is not seva, actually, it's karma. And in the evening time, one devotee is cooking, is not taking anything. He always thinking about the satisfaction of Bhagavan Sri Krishna. So, externally you can find it is all similar, but it's not similar. Morning time is karmi, and evening time, evening time doing same seva, is actually not karmi, is devotee. So, karmanya vadhikaraste ma phalishu kadachana. So, you have no right to think about the result of your karma. You can go on doing karma, and devotional karma, it's totally devotion, not actually karma. So, karmanya vadhikaraste ma phalishu is actually karmarpan. Those who are going to practice karmarpan, for them I'm speaking. Karmanya vadhikaraste ma phalishu kadachana. Actually, sadhar karma means sadharma vihita karma. Sadharma vihita karma is going to support your sadharma. So, it needs explanation actually. Karma, akarma, vikarma, I already explained, you can remember. Karma mean you are doing some activities already supported by Veda. This is called karma. Akarma mean you are not going to do anything which is supported by Veda. It's called akarma. Bikarma mean you are not going to do anything prescribed in Veda. You are doing just opposite. Bikarma is called bikarma. Just what is not prescribed in Veda, you are going to do all rubbish. It's called bikarma. So, karma, different kind of karmas there. Out of that, bikarma is dangerous. Bikarma is dangerous because it is not prescribed in Veda as a cause of your bond. Anything you are going to do which is not bhakti, there is also one kind of bondage. But karma still, if prescribed in Veda, you are doing. But in Bhagavatam, you can see, naiskarmam opi achyuta bhava varjitam na sabate jnanam amalam niranjanam. Naiskarmam opi, if achyuta bhava varjito, naiskarma, if not going to get the support of achyuta. Achyuta means Bhagavan Sri Krishna. If you are not going to take shelter of Achyuta, then that karma means also useless. It can put you in problem, trouble, you see. So, ma karma follow hetur bhumangste te sango astu karmani. So, out actually, toma sakram yadu karma. Actually, sadharma chito karma akarane tumar nyan nishchana hai. Bhagavan Sri Krishna, it is preliminary actually. In second canto, Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, those who have no right to go further, for them, Bhagavan Sri Krishna giving one by one argument. To Arjun, Bhagavan speaking this way, after that we can go and see, karma param, after that karma tag, actually, then speaking about Ganjog, gradually going up. So, for different kind of people, they have different kind of rights. They are not same right. For them, it is prescribed there. Sa dharma jito karma akarane. What is prescribed there in your sadharma? Sadharma mean? Sa dharma mean, actually, two kind of conception you can get. Sadharma mean actually, deep meaning, if you like to get the inner meaning, then it is the natural function of yourself, Krishna Bhakti. That here, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, all this material world, they cannot anyhow go out of the influence of their Varnasam Dharma. Varnasam Dharma is effective up to the point when their material bondage is there. 80% material bondage, 80% material bondage, 90%, 100% material bondage, or material bondage going to lose, maybe 20%, but still, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, until and unless they are going to go out of the influence of this material world, I mean, sato, rajo, tamo, gun, everything, so they have no right to leave karma. They cannot go out of Varnasam Dharma. In that case, Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking to Arjuna that you are Kshatriya. It is prescribed in Shastra for Kshatriya. You will have to do your job to, it is your duty to give full protection to countrymen. So this is your duty. So you should not avoid it. You have no right to avoid it. Be careful. Sadharma rajit, sadharma achito karma akarane. You are going to lose your interest to do your sadharma. So it should not be, you should not leave. So you have no right to leave it just now. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, that Varnasam Dharma is effective up to that point. If you are established in Atma Dharma, in that case, Varnasam Dharma cannot in that case, Varnasam Dharma cannot put any influence on you. You can go out of influence of this Varnasam Dharma. Karma karma vikarmeti vedobado na lokikaha vedasya che swaratma tat tatro muhyanti surayo. What to do, what not to do with this kind of fine judgment, even demigods, they are confused. They get confusion. They cannot understand. Karma karma vikarmeti vedobado na lokikaha. Vedasya che swaratma tat tatro muhyanti surayo. Ved is actually Ishvara. For different kind of people, different kind of prescription given there. But like marriage, like these, there, different kind of prescription there. But all, somebody speaking, it is there in Veda to sacrifice, you know, go, you know, different pasu, I mean, so it is there, they are showing, but actually not that. Actually, it is written there, but ultimately, what is written in Shastra, I can show you, those who cannot avoid this kind of sinful activities, for them, dangerous result they are going to get. So, if at all there is such prescriptions, there's some restriction put in front of them. Ultimately, it is written, why? To take them out of these sinful activities. It is written, somewhere different kind of prescription there. For tamaguna people, for rajaguna people, different kind of prescription there. But ultimately, Veda going to show, Veda going to show Krishna Bhakti. And what kind of result they can, what kind of result they can get, it is written in different shastra. Table, fearful situation they can meet. Those who are going to cut beast, this, that, sacrifice be in front of. Mahadev, Shankar Bhagavan speaking to Devi, O Devi, those who are going to sacrifice different kind of beast like goat, everything, camel in front of you, what is your judgment? Because you are Vaishnavi. Devi speaking, they are I am going to send them to hell forever. They cannot get respite, very dangerous. So, different kind of prescriptions are there for different kind of people, but ultimately Veda going to show them, Krishna Bhakti, which is the final solution. Now, 48 number slok speaking, Yogastho Kuru Karmani Sangyam Takta Dhananjayo. Yogastho Kuru Karmani means, Yogastho means try to, Yogastho Kuru Karmani Sangyam Takta Dhananjayo. You try to avoid different kind of association and try to settle down your mind. Yogastho means buddhi yog. Buddhi yog. Yogastho means, Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, Yogastho Kuru Karmani. First of all, you try to get my buddhi yoga. If this buddhi yoga, by the help of this buddhi yoga, if you are doing any karma, that is called Yogastho. Yogastho means, you try to Yogastho means actually you try to settle down your mind and buddhi yog, try to apply this technique which cannot put you in problem, bondage, that is called Yogastho Kuru Karmani. Sangyam Takta Dhananjayo. Different kind of associations are there, so you try to avoid those associations and try to apply those buddhi yog, that is called Yogastho Kuru Karmani. Sangyam Takta Dhananjayo. Siddhya Siddhyo Samabhutya Samattam Yoga Uchyate. What do you mean by yoga? It's the technique of yoga. It means Siddhi or Asiddhi. Siddhi means you can get success, you cannot get success. Siddhi Asiddhyo Samabhutya Siddhyo Bhajan Siddhyo Siddhyo Samabhutya Samattam Yoga Uchyate. What do you mean by yoga? If your mind can get this kind of situation, when you can never mind, either you are going to get success or failure. Siddhi Asiddhye Bhajan Siddhyo Siddhyo Samabhutya Samattam Yoga Uchyate. This technique is called yoga. With the help of this yoga, you can cut all different kind of, influence of the nature. You can cut. If you can apply this yoga, Yogastho Kuru Karmani Sangam Takta Dhananjayo, Siddhi Asiddhyo Samabhutya Samattam Yoga Uchyate, Krishna speaking, this kind of settle down of your mind, Samatta Buddhi. Now different kind of argument can come. Who is so fool? Who is so foolish? Without any target going to do any job? It is quite impossible. Who is going to do? Who is going to do anything? Who is going to do anything without any plan and program? Who is going to do anything without any purpose? Is quite impossible. Then somebody giving argument, that actually Siddhi, Asiddhi, Samabuddha, this Yogastho, Kuru Karmani, Sangam, Takta, Dhananjayo. So without purpose, who is interested to do anything? Service or material sangsar, anything. But actually, purposeless, aimless thing is separate and without any interest. I mean, Siddhi, Asiddhi, same mind, you can settle down your mind when you can never mind if you are going to come out successful or failure. This is totally different. Because those children, those small children, they are playing two groups, they are making two groups, they are playing, two team playing, but if sometime they are going to defeat one party, another party get victory, so they never mind. So purposeless, aimless, and aimless, this word is totally different, and samatva buddhi, samatva buddhi, buddhi yoga, totally different. Don't try to get confusion. Totally different thing. So now, Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, 49 number sloka, dure nahi avaram karmo buddhi yoga dhananjayo buddhyo saranam ichchana kripana phala hetavaha. He dhananjay, actually we are going to discuss about karmarpan. Yetu ishwar arpito niskam karma hite kamma karma oti nikrishto. Because anything I am going to do in this material, if I am going to give the result to Krishna, then because any karma has some result. Any karma, any action has its equal and opposite reaction. Like Newton theory. Every action has its equal and opposite reaction. So any karma you are going to do, you will have to get the result out of that. You cannot get respite. Karma fall you will have to get. So, but if you are going to get offer all the result to Krishna, then you are not going to suffer. Be careful. If you are going to give the result to Krishna, so niskam karma yoga, without any interest you are going to offer everything to Krishna. This procedure is more superior to kamma karma. With any kind of desire you are going to do karma, this is very dangerous. And this is very dangerous, can put you in trouble. So, phalkami, those who are going to expect different kind of result, they are actually kripan. Kripan means, you can remember from 11th canto, Bhagavan Sri Krishna putting question in front of Bhagavan Sri Krishna, Uddhav putting question, who is kripan? Who is actually miser? Miser actually, and who is actually buddhiman? Who is actually intelligent? Who is actually buddhiman? Who is actually intelligent? Who is actually kripan? Different kind of question, Uddhavji putting question. So, Bhagavan Sri Krishna giving answer, that those who are going to expect some result, or any action they are doing, they are going to expect some result, they are actually kripano. Actually, bandha mokshabit, kripano jastu atan, just kripano jastu ajitendriyaha. Those who are ajitendriyaha, same meaning actually, those who are ajitendriyaha mean they are not going to get control over their sense organ, same meaning, they are miche mayar vase jachya bheshe khachya habu dubu bhai, in Bengali. So they are just influenced by, they are actually following their master. They are going to follow their material mind, their master. They are going to follow material mind, their master. So they are actually kripon. Kripon means those who are not having any control over their sense organ, and kripono yastu atendriyo. And those who are bandha mokshavid. Bandha mokshavid means it can be the cause of bondage, it can be the cause of freedom. So these who are knowing, they actually jnani, tattva jnani. They are to have. So dure nahi avaram karmo buddhi yogo dhananjayo buddhyo saranamichya kripana phalahetavaha. Those who are kripan, miser, they always try to get some result out of their activities. Out of their activities, they like to get some fruitive activities they are doing. They going to get some, they always expecting some result. That's why they are miser actually. So, 15 number slog is speaking, buddhi yukto yahati ho uve sukrite duskrite. Buddhi yukto yahati ho uve sukrito duskrite. Tasmad yog yogayo yujasya yogah karmasu kausalam. What is the technique of karma? Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking. What is the technique of karma? Vachin buddhi yukto yahati ho. Buddhi yukto niskam karma yog yukto vyakti. Those who are taking shelter of that yoga, buddhi yog, they think it's same. They come outside, they are not going to express their grief. So buddhi yukto jahati ho, with buddhi yukto niskam karma yog yukto, when you are going to take shelter of this buddhi yog, then you can sukrito diskrito uvai jahati. Jahati means tag. They are going to live both results, sukriti and duskriti. Sukriti, sukrito duskrite. Buddhi yukto yahati. Yahati means tag kara. They are living. Buddhi yukto yahati ho uve, both sukriti and duskriti. Both. Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking that I am not going to give them inspiration from any kind of activities they are doing. They are automatically putting themselves in bondage. I am not responsible. I am not responsible for that. They are putting themselves in trouble. I am not going to put them in trouble. They are putting themselves in trouble. So, buddhi yukto yahati ho uve sukrite duskrite tasmad yogayo yujasya yogaho karmasu kausalam. So, with the shelter of this buddhi yog, this technique to do karma, it is called actually kaushal karma technique. Jetu niskam karma yoga nimitto jana. So, it is my advice, you try to at least concentrate on this factor. I mean, without expecting any result, because you are going to speak, this will happen. So it is my advice, you try to do your duty without any expectation. Buddhi yukto yahati ho uve sukrito duskrite tasmad yogai yujasya yogaho karmasu kausalam. This is the technique. So Janak Raja or big, you know, Rajas say they are also doing some karma, but they have their technique. So they are not going to put themselves in trouble. So they have some technique. Buddhi yukto. So in 51 it is written, karmajam buddhi yukta hi phalam tekta manishinaha janma karmo vinir mukta padam gachanti anamayam. Karmajam buddhi yukta hi phalam tekta manishinaha. Those who are manishina, manishi mean manishi, this word is applicable here. For them, those who are already settled down in buddhi yoga, no bondage is there. They can see past, present and future, the consequence of their activities. So, buddhi yukta munishinaha karmayam buddhi yukta hi phalam tyakta munishinaha janma karma vinir mukta padam gachanti anamayam. So, buddhi yog yukta munishiha, so they have their technique, they are doing everything without any affinity. Janak Maharaj, he is ruling whole world. Eh? Why? No interest they are doing. You can remember when Prahlad Maharaj, was not at all ready to take the seat of throne. Prahlad Maharaj never wanted to sit on this throne, Shinghasan, to rule the whole world. But still, Nishingade Bhagavan giving advice, you will have to do it, because you will have to act as a teacher. So Janak Maharaj, Adi, they are acting as teacher. They are engaging, they are going to engage all bonded souls in karma. Because if those important personalities not doing to do anything, then all common people, they can leave everything. They cannot do their sadharma. They can show that he is not doing, I cannot do. Bhagavan Sri Krishna also speaking this way. If I am not going to do, then they can leave doing everything. They have no right to leave. So in that case, big, you know, problem can be there. So, karmajam bhukti yuktahi phalam tyakta manishinaha, those manishi, they are also doing karma without expectation. Without expectation, they are doing. Buddhi yukta, buddhi yog, with application of buddhi yog. And it is actually not going to put you in trouble. Janmo, janmo bandhan minirmukta hoy, so they are going to cut their bondage. Janmo bandha binirmukta padam gachandi anamayam. Anamayam mean klesh shunno, where they cannot suffer, they need not suffer. Gachanti anamayam mean this transcendental abode, they are reaching. Anamayam, klesh shunno, they are not going to get any trouble. That's called anamayam. So, karmajam buddhi yuktahi phalam tyakta manishinaha janmo bandho binir muktaha padam gachanti anamayam. So, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, so with the application of this buddhi yoga, those actual pandits, they are doing activities, but they are not expecting any results. So, anyway, they are going to get free from material torture. It's not going to put them in trouble. So now, actually, 52 number sloka, yadate moho kalilam buddhir batitarishvati tada gantyasi nirvedam sratabhyasya sutasacha. Yadate moho kalilam buddhir batitarishvati. When your mind can go out of this, you know, moho kalilam mean actually, different. Mohu kalilam mean actually influence of maya. If you can go out of mohu kalilam, mohu mean hypnotize, you get lucrative offer, so you give some mohu. Oh, I can get it, this kind of. So jadate mohu kalilam, so gradually when you can totally cut all this kind of mohu, you know, influence, mohu kalilam buddhir bhati tarishvati, then you can, that is a vishesh, when you can cut all different kind of influence of, you know, who is going to put you in trouble and give some, you know, put you in trouble. So gradually if you can cut all different kind of bondage, in that case you can easily understand in Veda something written, which is the cause of your bondage, which all are the cause. Yada gantyasi nirvedam. In that case, automatically you can go. In that case, automatically you can grow some nirved. Mane nirved mean totally we are less interested to do. And totally you can lose your interest. Nirved. Nirved mean totally out of the influence of Maya. Nirved. Now, no kind of, you know, offer. No kind of lucrative offer can put you in trouble. So, tada gantyasi nirvedam sratavyasya sutasya cha. Then you can understand that, and you know, buddhi yukta rava, tomar buddhi sampurna rava prithakarva. Then in that case you can understand everything. What is written in Veda, sratavya sutasya. Mana that those kind of different kind of offer written there in Veda, you can grow detachment for that, nirved. This, gradually you can grow nirved, detachment for that. You are not going to put yourself in trouble. So, yadate moho kalilam buddhir vyati tarishati. Tada gantyasi nirvedam sratavyasya sutasya cha. 53, it is written, Shruti vipatipanya te yada sthasati nishala samadhu achala buddhis tada yogam avapshati. When Shruti vipatipanya te yada sthasati nishala. When different kind of, you know, offer written in Veda, you can understand everything, then you are not going to be influenced by those offers. In that case, you can grow detachment, nishchala anasakta, you can grow detachment, asikture. In that case, samadhu parameshwar, antura lotus feet of Krishna, you can, you know, samadhu means onto the lotus feet of Krishna, you can concentrate your mind, sthir. Then your mind can get tranquil situation, tranquility, sthir, restless. And in that case, you can understand the actual result of this bhakti yoga. You can understand. If your mind is restless and less resting onto the lotus feet of Krishna, in that case, you can understand that what is called actual buddhi yoga, yogam abhavshashi, aga abhavshashi, shruti vipratipanya te yada sthasyati nishchala, samadhu achala buddhis tada yogam abhavshati. In that case, actually you can start this buddhi yoga, you can start. 53. Now 54, now Arjun asking, the sthita pragnyasya ka bhasa samadhistasyo keshavo sthitadhi king prabhasati prabhaseta kim asid brajat kim. Sthita pragnyasya means whose intellect is, you know, heart is already resting on Krishna. Sthita pragnyasya ka bhasa, what, how he is speaking, how he is acting, how he is working, different, all his activities. What is the symptom? Arjuna asking, sthita-pragyasya ka bhasa? Sthita-pragya, those who are already sthita-pragya, they are, what is the symptom? How they are speaking? How they are staying? How they are working? Prabhasit kim asit brajat kim? Sthita-pragyasya ka bhasa samadhi-stasyo keshava, hey Keshav, Arjun asking, sthita-pragyasya ka bhasa, how they are speaking, samadhi-stasyo keshava, how they settle down their mind, and sthita-dhi king pravaseta, how they are working, how they are leading their life, what is the symptom? Lakhan, you like to know different kind of symptoms. Or those sthitadhi people, those who are actually settled on their mind, those who are intellects resting unto the lotus feet of Krishna. They like to know the symptom, their symptom. They are so like to know the symptom. Arjun want to get advice from Krishna. Now Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking. Prajohati yada kamano sarvano partho manogatano atma nevatmana tushtoho sthita pragyo stadochati. What is the symptom of the sthita pragyo people? How we know? Prajohati, prajohati means totally prajohati prakishto rupena jahati. Prajohati yada kamano. When you find that, you know, sthita-pagga people, what is the symptom? They are totally out of any kama, attachment, totally. Prajohati yada kamano, when one can go out of any kind of kama, totally, no smell, prajohati, that's why, prajohati yada kamano sarvano, any kind of, no trace of kama, they are residue. No smell of kama. So, prajohati yada kamano sarvano partho manogatano. From mind is totally free now. Atma nevatmana tushto. He is now satisfied with his self. Atma. Follow. Atma nevatmana tushto. He is satisfied with himself. Atma. With Atma. Atma nevatmana tushtaha sthito pragyo stadochate. In that case, you can see, you can understand that he is sthito pragyo. He is satisfied in himself. He is satisfied in himself. In that case, you can understand he is sthito pragyo. Otherwise, he is not sthito pragyo. So, all different kind of symptoms, Krishna speaking. So, 56, number sloka. Dukheshu anudvigana mana sukheshu vigata spriha. In dukha, when we are in misery, we are actually feeling our, you know, bad feeling coming. So here Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, dukheshu anudvigana mana, when different kind of painful situation coming in his life, he is not at all going to put any influence on that sthita-pagga people. Dukheshu anudvigna mana. He is not in anxiety, expressing any anxiety. Dukheshu anudvigna mana sukheshu vigata spriha. So, if you put him in misery, still no anxiety. Sukheshu vigata spriha. Sukheshu vigata is less interested about a blissful situation, bliss situation, pain and pleasure. Pain and pleasure all same for him. He is not going to be influenced by painful situation or pleasure. So, bitoraga bhayakradaha, bitoragaha, bitorag mean is going to grow detachment, no attachment for any material thing. Bito-raga means bigato-ragaha, bito-ragaha, vayakrodo, bhai, fear and crowd, anger, all vanish. Bito-ragaha, vayakrodaha, sthito-dhir muniruchyate. So actually, it is called actually krodh-sunno, is no thirsty for enjoyment, no fear, no krodha, I mean anger, nothing. In that case, you can understand, he is actually sthita pragyo. Sthita pragyo, in that case, you can understand, he is surely sthita pragyo. Ya sarvatranabhisnehostattatprapposubhasubham navinandati na deshti stasya pragyapatishthita. How we can know that he is sthita pragyo? Ya sarvatra anabhisnehus tattat prapya subhashubham. In this material world, nothing in this material world, nothing going to influence him. No attraction. Attraction, neither affection nor repulsion, nothing. Yo sarvatra anavishneho stattat prapo shubha shubham. Shubho evang ashubho, bad or good, anything coming in his life, he is merciless. No, not going to get any influence. Yo sarvatra anavishneho stattat prapo shubha shubham. Good or bad, anything coming in his life, he has no interest in it. Na abhinandanti, na deshti, not going to, you know, welcome, so welcome, or not going to desh mean, you know, videsh, repulsion, not at all there. Na abhinandanti, na deshti, this situation is called the situation of sthitapragna people. This condition is the condition of sthitapragna people. There is a symptom. So, now 58, yada sangharate chayam kurmo, yada sangharate chayam kurmo anga niva sarvasaha indriyani indyarthe bhyo stasya pragna patishthitaha. Like tortoise, you can understand. If any problem happens, tortoise can take all limbs, hands and leg inside body. Yada sangharate chayam kurmo anga niva sarvasaha, all his different limbs, hands and legs and, you know, head, mouth, all taking inside the seal. Seal. So yada sangharate chayam kurmo anga niva sarvasaha, indriya-nindya-arthebhyo-stasya-pragna-patishthitaha. He always thinking, my sense organ doing their respective activities, I have no relation with that. Indriya-nindya-arthebhyo-stasya-pragna-patishthitaha. So, who, there he is sthita-pragna, in front of, you know, any kind of thing, attractive thing, or, you know, anything which is dangerous, he can settle down his mind, he can cough, all his hands and leg, mind, he can only think that my sense organ engage in, you know, sense matters, I have no attachment with that. So, Yakan Muni Gurvan. So he can automatically, in situation which is dangerous, like, I can give you one example, Siringa Muni first, and Sukhdev Goswami also. Sukhdev Goswami was tested by whom? Janak Maharaja. Sukhdev Goswami was totally tested by Janak Maharaj. He was put in adverse situation, different kind of women, everything. But Sukhdev Goswami was totally less interested. No influence was there. So this way, actually, opposite situation, anytime Supreme Lord can test you, can put you in opposite situation. In that case, if you can come out successful, I mean, indriyani indyarthebhyo tasya pragna patishthita yada sangharate chayam kurma anganiva sarvasaha, like kurma means tortoise can, you know, take inside all his limb. Same way, all sense organ there with the sthitapragna people, not going to put him in trouble. Automatically he can get control over his sense organ. Iska indriyani indyarthebhyo stasya pragna patishthita. In that case you can understand that he is sthitapragna, surely he is sthitapragna. His mind is settled down unto the lotus feet of Krishna. You can be sure about it. So any kind of attraction or repulsion cannot put him in trouble. So yada sangharate chayam kurumangya niva sarvashaha indriyani indyarthebhyo stasya pragna patishthita. His pragna is patishthita. Visaya vinivartante nirahasa dehinaha raso varyam raso pasya param dishtha nivartante. Visaya vinavartante niraharo sadehinaha. Somebody can show false detachment. Somebody can show false detachment for matters. Whereas, he is not successful to get control over his sense organ. He is totally failure. But externally, he can show false, you know, detachment. So, Krishna speaking, Visaya vinivartante niraharo sadehinaha. Those who are fasting to get control over sense organ, this is not the actual procedure. Krishna speaking, you will have to do all balanced way. You have to sleep balanced way. You have to take prasadam balanced way. You will have to do everything balanced way. Otherwise, all you have to do balanced, yukta vairagya is called. So if you are not going to apply this formula of yukta vairagya, then maybe you can show vairagya detachment, false detachment, but you cannot come out successful. Because visaya vinivartante niraharasa dehinaha, externally you can find somebody, in the other so in the other visagana asamartho, if your sense organ, like you are growing old age, 80 years, in that case, all your sense organ not working properly. In that case, you are going to show detachment. But actually, not that. You are going to show that you are growing detachment. But Krishna speaking, no. Maybe 80 years of age, 80 years old, but externally you can find he is unable to enjoy matters. He cannot take nice prasadam, he cannot enjoy material enjoyment. It is not actually detachment. Actually, he is unable. He is unable. That's why he is going to show detachment. This is not actually detachment. Niraharasya India, those sense organs become weak in old age. In that case, you have the scope to think that he is having detachment. Not that. Actually, this is not detachment. Rasa varjam rasa pasa param dishtani vartante. Actually, you can grow that kind of detachment when you can get higher rasa. If you can get higher rasa, aprakita rasa, only then you are going to live material rasa. Follow? Rasa varjam rasa pasya, rasa varjam rasa pasya, param dishta nivartante. Rasa varjam, material rasa. You can avoid material rasa provided you are going to feel some attraction for aprakita rasa. If you are going to feel some attraction for aprakita rasa, in that case, you can avoid prakita rasa. I mean bhakti. Without that, you have no right to pass away attraction. So, vishaya vinivartante niraharasa dehinaha raso varjam raso pasya param drishta nivartante. So, sometimes some yogi, some jnani, they can show some detachment. But many such cases there we can show from Shastra, they are doing yoga. Sometimes they are going to break their yoga. You can know? Sauvari Rishi. So many cases there. So, they break their yoga again, they feeling attraction from material thing. So, raso varjam raso pasya, he can avoid material rasa provided he is going to get higher rasa. Raso varjam raso pasya param dishtha nivartanti. So, in that case, he can paramatmo so atacho sridhapagya bhaktir paramatma ke dasan kuriya. So, automatically, if he can have the scope to meet with Supreme Lord, in that case, automatically you are going to leave everything. Otherwise, you cannot leave. 60, the last shloka I can speak today. Yatato hi opi kantiya purusasya vipaschitaha indriyani pramathini haranti prasabham manaha yatato opi kantiyo he kantiyo he arjun. Sometimes somebody trying to get control over sense organ, but still they become failure. Yatato hi opi kantiyo purushasya vipaschitaha. Vipaschita murusato viveki purush, those who have their good and bad reasoning power, but still so strong mind, material mind is so strong, so you can get defeated. Like Ajamil, get defeated, and Maya going to put influence on him. Yatato hi opi, he is trying, though. Yatato hi opi, though you are trying. Yatato hi opi kantiyo purushasya vipaschito, though somebody trying his best, but still, viveki puri, those who are having good and bad, this conception, vipaschitaha, indriyani pramathini, is like strong wind, this strong wind, indriyani pramathini, haranti prasabham mano, somehow, your mind can be taken away by a strong wind of maya. This. So, yatato hi opikantiya purushasya vipaschita, sometimes it is seen. Those who are not sitapagya actually, they are trying their best to show their detachment from matter, but not so easy. So, yatato hi opikantiya purushasya vipaschita ha, indriyani pramathini haranti prasabham mano, gradually, today or tomorrow, his mind can be taken away by the strong blow of Maya. He cannot stand there, like Ajamil, everything. So, you cannot deserve that you are having control over your sense organ. Always you will have to cry. In Bhakti Yoga, that is the procedure. Yatato hi api kantiya purusasya vipaschitaha indriyani pramathini haranti prasabham manaha. Anytime durbar indiya kare, actually Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking, durbar indiya kare vishaya gohan daru prakriti hare munuropimon. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving punishment to choto haridas, small haridas, in that case this word is speaking, durbar indiya kare vishaya gohan. Durbar indiya mani, the indriya is very dangerous. All sense organs, they are having some respective demand, always demanding matters. So, durbar indriya kare vishaya gaon. Durbar meaning, no, you cannot get control over sense organ. Durbar indriya kare vishaya grahon. All your different sense organs want to get different matters. Jiv hai kato achyuta vikar sati ma vidipta sishna anna tara stak udaram sabanam kutaschit. This sloka I can discuss. Today my mood is not good. Half an hour, 1 hour I lost in starting. So tani sarvani sangyamma yukto asito matparaha vasehi yasendriyani tasya pragya patishchit. Tani sarvani sangyamma yukto asito matparaha. Tani sarvani in stani sarmani sangyamma yukto asita matparaha. Matparaha means have some attachment for Supreme Lord. Growing some affinity for Supreme Lord. Matpara. Asita matparaha. And actually, matparayan bhakti yogi. Actually, those who are devotee, matparayan bhakti yogi, they can take shelter of yukto vairagya. They can get control over all sense organ, and they can get control over their sense organ, and their mind is actually sthitapagya. Their mind, they are already established, so their mind is settled down. That's why they are actually successful. They, you can say, they are actually sthitapagya, actual sthitapagya. Tani sarvani sangyammo, tani min bonded indriya, all respective indriya. Tani, mane indriyani. Trani sarvani sangyammo, sangyamannu controlling. Yukto asita matparaha, yukto vairagya, and doing bhakti unto lotus feet of Krishna, Matparamin Krishna is doing those who are showing bhakti to me, asitama yukta, sangyamma, tani sarvani sangyamma yukta, asitama matparaha, vasehi asendriyani, automatically they can get control of our sense organ. Actually, you can say they are actually sthitapagga. They are actually true. Actually, they are sthitapagga. So, nobody can put them in trouble. No situation can put them in trouble. There is a success. I can discuss in detail next day. Today, my mood is not good.